Okay, so this video is going to cover calculations with measurements, considering precision and accuracy when it comes to our measurements. So, remembering precision and accuracy. Remember, accuracy is how many significant digits you have in a measurement. Precision is what place value is it precise to. So here at the bottom of the screen, I have the steps and how to do calculations with measurements. Step one. Make sure all measurements have the same unit. Every once in a while, you may be given an example where one measurement's in inches, one is in feet, one might be in miles, or something else like that. Well, you can't just calculate with them that way. You would have to make sure that they all were in the same unit. So you would have to convert everything to inches, or something like that. So that's our first step. So taking a look at this example, we have the same measurement. We're talking about seconds here, right? So 5.75 seconds, 2.3 seconds. So we're good. Step two, calculate as is. So go ahead and calculate what it's asking you to. So add, subtract, multiply, divide, whatever the problem is asking you to do. So if we take 5.75 minus 2.3, we get 3.45. Our next step is to round to the least precise unit. So let's take a look at that. If I'm looking at the 5.75 seconds, right, that is precise up into the hundredths place, right? So I have three significant digits. I don't have any zeros in the problem, so I don't need to worry about that. So this five right here, which is in the hundredths spot, is my most precise. Taking a look at the 2.3, right, both of those are significant numbers. The three, right, is my rightmost significant number, so that's what I'm concerned with, and that is in the tenths spot. So when it comes to comparing these two, I have the one for the hundredths, one for the tenths. I need to round to the least precise unit. Tenths is least precise than the hundredths. Okay, so taking my answer into consideration, 3.45, I need to round that to the least precise unit, which is the tenths. So I need to round it to the tenths place. So to the right of the tenths place, I have a 5, which is going to tell me to round up. So my answer here would actually be 3.5 seconds. So we're just taking our measurements, making sure that they're in the same unit, calculating that, and then making sure that we are rounding our final answer to the least precise of those units. Okay, so our next example here, 3.146 feet times 2.2 feet. So first off, they are both in feet, so we don't need to calculate or convert any measurements here. So this is multiplication. So the first thing we need to do is take 3.146 times 2.2. And when we plug and chug that into the calculator, we get 6.9212. Okay, so after we calculate, we need to round to the least precise unit. So taking a look at my first measurement, that is precise to the thousandths place. Taking a look at my second measurement, that is precise to the tenths. So the tenths is less precise than the thousandths. So that means I need to take my answer right here and round that to the tenths place, which I have a 9 in the tenths place. To the right of that, we have a 2. So that means that's going to round down. So my final answer for this example is 6.9 feet. Okay, so our final example here, we have 12.6 inches plus 1 feet. 5 inch minus 5.3 inches. So here we do need to be concerned with step number one. We need to make sure that all of our measurements have the same unit, right? So let's work on that first. So looks like almost everything else is given to us in inches except for our middle measurement. That one is given to us 1 foot, 5 inches. Well, feet, thankfully, is a measurement that we should be familiar with. Remember, 1 foot is equal to 12 inches, right? So that 1 foot is 12 inches plus that 5 inches that we also have right over there. So 12 inches plus 5 inches gives us 17 inches. So what we're actually going to calculate is 12.6 inches plus 17 inches minus 5.3 inches. Okay, so when we actually do that calculation, we should get 24.3 inches. Now we need to round to the least precise unit. So taking a look at our measurement, our first measurement here is precise to the tenths. Our second measurement is precise to the ones. And our third measurement is precise to the tenths. So our least precise is to the ones. So we need to take our answer and round it to the ones place. So we have a 4 in the ones place. To the right of that, we have a 3, which tells us to round down. So our final answer would actually be 24 inches.